Hello, this is Christy. Let me show you how you can zoom in and out on screen recordings in Descript. When you record your screen in Descript, Descript records several files. It records your webcam, if it's enabled. It records an audio file, which is your sound. And then it also records your screen if you are sharing your screen. So several files are being recorded at the same time. So if you're recording a tutorial in Descript, for example, like I recorded this Camtasia tutorial, and if you look in the media bin, you will notice that it has a sequences folder. And inside of that sequences folder, you have a sequence there, which actually usually has the names of all the files involved. And in this case, it says Christy and Christy's iPhone camera and Christy and screen. So several things going on in there. And in fact, you see the recordings folder contains Christy and Christy's iPhone camera, which is my audio and my iPhone camera, and also Christy and screen. So it recorded me on two files, okay? So this sequence, actually, I like to go in and have a look at what it did. Right-click on it and say Edit Sequence. And you can see here, these are the two tracks. One of them has audio and the other one is the screen. So just to make it easy for you, I will rename these two layers because I want to know which ones they are. So I'm going to click on the left-hand side here where the name of the track is. Let me just zoom in. And then this is going to be webcam. Let's call this webcam. It's my iPhone. And this one is going to be screen. Okay. So now we know which file, which track is which layer. So click done. And click the media bin, and I already transcribed these files as I recorded them, and this composition has been created from my tutorial, which is 5 minutes long. And now I want to see how can I zoom in. Okay, so I'm just going to show you how you can zoom in. I'm going to make the timeline taller, and for zooming in, we're going to use animations. And I know that Descript has some built-in zooming in animations, but I like to do custom animations because they give you more control, okay? If I click outside of the canvas area, you look on the right-hand side and you see the two layers that I just renamed, webcam and screen. So what I want to do is I want to lock the webcam because I don't want to click on it and move it around, although I can look if I move it around. This is my camera. I have applied the green screen effect to it, so it's removed my background, the chroma key. So I like to keep my camera in the corner, as you know. And here we go. This is the screen, and I want to zoom in. Let's assume that I want to zoom into an area in the top left corner on my screen here, but I want to zoom in with a little animation, okay? So I'm going to make the screen larger, and let's find a place to zoom in to see. So in this case, I like to keep organized and add markers. Okay, so it doesn't matter what I say on the video, but I would say I would like to click and start the animation right about here on the 3 minute 32. So let's click on the layer that I want to zoom, which is the screen layer. You know, you see it right there. And then I'm going to go to animation, click the plus sign, and you can see you have already some built-in animation like zoom in. Let's try that one. Click zoom in. And you can see now that in the timeline, there is an animation. It's very hard to see on the new timeline in Descript, but you can see this little diamond here and this blue line, and then there's another diamond here. Those are the animation keyframes. I'm not crazy about the positioning. You can move them around and change their distance between them, right? So you see Descript has already scaled my video quite close. So I can click on this keyframe here and move my video to the top left corner. Let's assume that this is where I wanted to move my video to zoom in, right? So now if I move to the first keyframe and press play, watch this. So in this case, I like to keep organized and add markers. So the animation is a little bit too slow because it lasts for like 5 seconds. I want to do that faster. So that means I grab this keyframe and drag it to about halfway through here. Okay, let's play it again or to see. So in this case, I like to keep organized. That's quite nice, you know. And you notice that it includes a little easing. So there is easing on the animations in Descript now. And if you click on this again and go to animation, you see ease in. It's got ease in there. So this was recently added so that Descript zooms in, starts a bit slow, then speeds up, and then slows down at the end of the keyframe. So that makes the animation seem a little more natural or human. So that's my animation right there. If I click on this to go back to see the keyframes, now I want to zoom out again. So I want to go back to the previous state. Unfortunately, for some odd reason, Descript does not include a zoom out or a fit to screen animation. So it's not very easy to go back to having the video full screen. So we're going to have to improvise that, okay? So I'm going to place my playhead here. Let's suppose that I want to go from here. I want to go back to full screen on my video. So again, I click on my screen recording and I have to add another animation. Click plus again. And you can see here there's the zoom in. There's no zoom out, okay? So I'm going to say custom this time. Create a custom animation. Again, Descript makes it about 5 seconds long, which is too much. Too slow. I'm going to grab that keyframe and pull it back a little bit right here. Okay. And this is how animation works. You basically control what happens in the two keyframes. Where your video starts, that's the first keyframe, and where your video ends up, which is the second keyframe. So I have to be selecting that second keyframe and I want to change my video. Now, I could grab the video and move it around, which would move it around, or I could grab the corners, resize it, move it in the corner and resize the corner again and make sure it fits. That's one way to do it. And we've done it. Look, if I play here, change quiz to marker, it goes back to full screen. So that is the only way you can go back at the moment to go back to the full screen is by just resizing the video and making it fit on the screen itself. That is a little tedious and I am not crazy about it, but there you go. That's the one way to do it. There used to be controls to do 100% and fit the screen and fill the screen. None of those controls seem to be available when you do the zooming in and out, apparently, when animations are involved. So there's still a bit of work needed on Descript's part in that. It would be great if there was an animation, just like Camtasia does, where you have a restore animation or a go back to the previous position and size animation. That would be nice because it would remember the first position that you had your video in, and then you would be able to maybe paste that or go back to the same one at a different keyframe. We can only hope that this happens. I hope this makes sense and I hope this is useful. If you use the zoom and pan animation, let me know how that goes. There's another animation already built in, so you can go in here and you can go, instead of creating your custom animation, you can just say animation plus zoom and pan, and then it creates another animation. Again, it's like 5 seconds long and that does the same thing. It just zooms you in and allows you to go to whatever position you want, and there it is, marker. And you can give names to these markers. For example, I'm going to say slide 2. So if I want to go back now, plus another animation, zoom and pan, and now this one doesn't zoom you in anymore because you're already zoomed in. This one zooms you in even more. Okay, so the only way to go back is to basically just grab the object, resize it a few times. Make sure you don't touch other layers, you know, just make sure you're not moving something you don't want to move. And here we go. If you don't fit, just pull it some more and resize it. As long as you're in that second keyframe, you're good. Here we go. It starts there. And slide 1, obvious, and it goes to full screen. So there you have it. I hope this was useful. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.